Beyond the largest ocean, behind the most distant mountains, and across the widest valley, exists a mystical and enchanted forest. The creatures who call this magic place their home learned long ago to live in harmony with each other. The forest provides for all their needs and is an endless source of wonder and adventure. Hard at work within this peaceful setting are the pixies of the forest, the tiny creatures known as the Littlebits. From sunup to sundown, they plant and cultivate, harvest and store the fruit and vegetables that grow so abundantly in the woods around them. No one knows where the Littlebits come from or how long they've been watching over their wooded gardens, but everyone accepts them as part of nature's plan, as familiar as the sun and the rain. Because they're so tiny, the Littlebits have had to come up with clever methods to carry out their chores. But with teamwork and enthusiasm, they always get the job done.
Off you go!
And have a good time along the way.
And hurry back! We'll have another load ready for you in a few minutes!
The Littlebits are used to hard work, and no one ever complains because they know how important it is to make the forest a happy place to live. On this particular morning, there's even more activity than usual. It's time for the yearly celebration of spring planting, when all the children cast their votes for the most popular boy and girl in the village. Whoever wins is crowned king and queen of the festival, so of course everyone's very excited, especially Lillibit.
Come on, Blue! We can't lay around or we're gonna be late for the contest!
Even when she's in a hurry, Lillibit always has a warm smile and a cheery word for everyone around her.
Isn't it a lovely day?
Hi, Lillibit.
Hi there. Hard at work already, huh? Maybe I'll come back later and help.
All right. I'll see you then.
Bye. No fair, Blue. I don't have my swimsuit on. I bet I can still beat you across, though.
You're going over to vote?
What do you mean?
You know, to pick the king and queen of the spring festival.
Oh, yeah.
Almost forgot.
I was going to ask you to walk over with me if you weren't too busy.
Sounds great.
Wait, I was going to ask you, but I can see you're going to work, and that's more important. Why don't you come over after you're done? I'll see you when you get there. Bye!
Gee, she sure changes her mind quickly.
Snuffly! Come on, Snuffly! Wake up!
We've got to get going, sleepyhead!
You okay?
We're going to the spring festival. Can you come with us?
Yeah.
Good! Race you! This is gonna be the best festival we've ever had!
Even though it's early morning, many of the Littlebits are already busy decorating the town hall for the evening celebration.
Well, Mr. Mayor, everything's going along fine. The old town hall hasn't looked this good since last year's festival.
If you ask me, we should add some pizzazz to the celebration. Something like a big parade.
Oh, no, Mr. Mayor. It's important that we honor the traditions of our ancestors. The festival should take place in the same way as it always has.
I hope I can stay awake.
Elderbit? Where do we find out who gets to be the king and queen?
Well, bless my soul. I almost forgot. Hey, It's time to count the votes and see who's the most popular! We're about to find out who you've chosen! Let me see... The first vote is Lillibit for queen and Snagglebit for king! This one says Merrybit for queen and Willibit for king. The next says Lillibit for queen and Teddybit for king. Snagglebit for king and Lillibit for queen. Willibit for king and Lillibit for queen. And next we have Teddybit for king and Merrybit for queen.
I hope they choose me and Lillibit's most popular kids. Then I'll surprise her with these flowers and she'll like me.
Lillibit for queen and Willibit for king.
Willibit and Lillibit should be elected. They're the most popular.
What?
Here's another one for Willibit and Lillibit.
I wonder why Snagglebit isn't getting more votes. He's my son. He must be popular.
Willibit and Lillibit. Willibit and Lillibit again.
Hey, Browniebit, did you vote for me?
Of course.
Willibit and Lillibit. That's all of them. The king and queen for this year's festival are Willibit and Lillibit.
Lillibit, you and Willibit are this year's king and queen.
What a surprise.
I'll show them. They'll be sorry they didn't pick me.
That's great. I can't wait to tell Willibit. Snuffly, take me to his house.
Yeah.
Isn't it amazing? She's the only one of us who can talk to the animals. Willibit will be so excited.
Ready for your lunch now, dear?
Mm-hmm.
Good. I've made your favorite casserole.
Oh, boy.
I might have known Mom would make me babysit. When's she coming back?
Pretty soon, I think.
Hey, Willie! Huh? I have great news!
Yeah, what?
You won't believe this, but you and I were voted king and queen of the Spring Festival.
You're kidding! They already voted?
Yup, and they just announced the results!
Yay!
Can you come?
Hey, sure, if you can wait a little while. I told Papa I'd help him with his job!
Oh, what does he have to do?
Help Mr. Grape float his boat downstream. But it shouldn't take long.
No, especially if I help, too.
Here come Mom and Papa now!
Hi!
Oh!
How are you, Mr. and Mrs. Grumpabit? You're looking very well.
Thanks, Lillibit.
That's sweet of you to say.
We better get moving, Pop. We got work to do.
Is that my son Willibit talking? Hard to believe.
He's happy. He and Lillibit were chosen to be king and queen of the festival.
Oh. Congratulations, you two. That's quite an honor.
I guess we better get going.
I want to go too, Papa.
Well, you'd better stay home with me.
Oh, I never get to go anywhere.
We're all set. You ready down there?
Yeah, we've got a good grip.
Whoa! Hang on tight, Willibit. They're gonna lower you to the wagon. All right, good.
Easy now. That's the way. We'll get this down to the stream for you, Mr. Grape. Why don't you take a little break?
Think I will. Thanks.
We'll be back in just a few minutes. Everybody ready to go? Okay, push!
Your papa's real strong, Willibit. I bet he could pull this whole wagon all by himself.
This went a lot faster than I expected. You two have really been helpful.
I think one more trip will do it, don't you?
That sounds about right. We'd better hurry and get finished.
Yes, sir.
Here we go!
Won't they be surprised when they come back and find their boat's gone? There's the side stream I was looking for. I said I'd find a way to get even with those two, and now I will. This is gonna work out great. I'll hide this boat somewhere downstream. Willibit and his father will think it drifted away. They'll be so upset they'll search everywhere, even if it takes all night. But they won't find it, and with Willibit out of the way, I can take his place as king of the Spring Festival.
Very good. Make sure it's nice and tight now.
Yes, sir. We're almost ready.
Snuffly, it's time to get up. We're gonna be leaving soon.
What happened? Are you all right? What? You say the boat with the grapes is floating away?
I guess this is far enough. I should look for a place to tie up somewhere around here.
It's a mistake. Our boat has to be here. Oh, no. It is gone.
You're not going alone, are you?
There's only room for one in this boat.
Be careful, Willibit. It's dangerous.
Don't worry. I can take care of myself.
Oh, brother! How do I get myself into these messes?
To the side of the stream. I talked to Mr. Deer and he says he'll help us.
That's terrific.
If you hurry, we can still catch the boat. Hold on to his nose. He'll lift you up the rest of the way.
Whoa.
All right, let's go.
Oh, my God.
Lillibit? Snagglebit, are you all right?
Hey, you must have swallowed a lot of water.
Yeah, but it's all right now. You're safe.
You mean I'm alive? Somebody rescued me?
What did you think? We were gonna let you drown? Tell me something. How did you get on the boat anyway?
Well, you see, it happened like this. I was down on the bank playing. I saw the boat come loose, and I got so caught up trying to save it that I just jumped right in.
Well, don't worry about losing the boat and all. The important thing is, you're safe.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
I used to think you weren't very nice, but I have to admit I was wrong about you, Snagglebit. We better get back to the village. I'm sure they're worried about us, and we have to get ready for the festival.
That night, when the moon had risen to its highest point, all the Littlebits gathered in the clearing in front of their town hall and waited with great anticipation to see the new king and queen of the spring festival.
The festival will now light the ceremonial torch. Listen to me, all of you who have gathered here. This is a time of renewal and rejoicing, a time when we celebrate the bounty of nature and the promise of our youth. Let there be no sadness on this night, only the sounds of great celebration. Now let the festival begin!
This festival's getting better all the time!
Doesn't Lillibit look handsome up there?
What a charming queen! Great party, huh?
Oh, young at heart, young at heart!
Lillibit, you're enjoying yourself. I'm glad for her.
Into the night, a grand celebration filled with laughter and joyful festivities. Once again, it was time to renew the cycle of the seasons, and the Littlebits marked the occasion in their own special way, just as they'd done for generations past, and just as they will do for generations to come.
Hey, you made it to the end of the episode. That's awesome. If you like our videos, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe. If you're in a position to help out the channel, consider supporting us on Patreon. Be sure to check out our Facebook page where you can keep up to date with us. And go ahead and watch another episode of your favorite nostalgic cartoons right here at the Cartoon Vault.